I mean, to me, it still acts like it's running, but I don't know.
Well, best
because the little dot is. You see that it's ticking time, but the REC isn't up there anymore.
See?
Okay. No. Go ahead.
Let me tape it for you. In javelin. Now don't scratch Scott.
I'm not going to tell Scott about that.
Jessica? Yeah, he does get psyched. Don't scratch. See, I think until he's in, you have to walk out the back. There's all these rules.
We never have to use any of them.
Couldn't hear him. Oh, I can't do this. I don't need. There's no. I really don't know how to do this. I have no clue what I'm doing. Shoot.
Well, you're ahead of him. 137.
137? To move up? Well, that was your warm-up. Uh-oh, false start.
That's the second one.
Oh, I must have missed the first one. Did you hear anything about somebody getting...
Well,
he's still in sixth then. All the throws are less in finals than they were in prelims.
Yeah, that's what usually happens. They get tired.
Oh.
He's overthrown.
He did the same thing as he did.
Did he do the quarters first and we got that brand new discus?
That was expensive. Well, although our other one was illegal, so we didn't really have much choice, did we?
Well, we know we could have bought a rubber one, which we let me buy both a rubber and a wood one, but
yeah.
I told him, I said, Scott's
Scott got attached to that. Yeah. I think on that very last throw when he
Cook of Hazen, the throw of 153 feet 10 inches, and the winner of the boys' javelin from Washburn High School, Nate Brunsell, with a throw of 165 flat. Best time turned in prior to this meet was by Courtney Loon of Standing Rock, a time of 439 flat. First call, boys, 400 meter relay. First call, boys, 400 meter relay. Courtney Loon of Standing Rock at the end of the first lap.
Oh, keep scratching. It's his last chance. He's only 5 feet off of making second place, but he hasn't had a good throw since his first one. Dang it.